Hi, we're Champagne, and you're watching Inside the Game. Let's go, Eagles!
Now, that's a great way to celebrate some championships and huge rivalry games, don't you think? Anyway, it's time to crown a champion in the SIAC, and the folks at Benedict, well, they're looking for two. An emotional weekend at North Carolina Central. Legendary Hall of Famer Sam Jones returns, and the Aggies are in town. Oh, it's going to be fun in Durham. Nothing says rivalry better than the Battle of the Bay, particularly on Senior Day. Norfolk State, Hampton, on the hardwood again. So get ready. It's time to go Inside the Game, presented by Toyota. Durham, North Carolina, McDougal, McClendon Arena. We're watching, you're watching, I'm watching Inside the Game presented by Toyota. Now, Eagles and Aggies are playing for the 175th time on the men's side, and we'll talk more about that in a little bit. But we're going to watch another MEAC rivalry up in the Battle of the Bay. That's right, Hampton and Norfolk State. Now, Norfolk State won the first matchup a couple of weeks ago. Hampton and Ed Joyner Jr. want revenge. It's going to be a good game because they always are anytime it's a rivalry game. So let's go to Hampton, Virginia, where the North Carolina Central Eagles are keeping their eyes on this game because Hampton and Norfolk State are playing.
It was senior night for the Hampton Pirates. Emmanuel Okoroba, the lone senior, being honored as they took on Norfolk State in the Battle of the Bay Part 2. The Spartans, with a win, would lock up second place for the upcoming MEAC tournament. HU off to a fast start, and no one was hotter on the court than Dwight Meikle. Off the alley-oop from Deron Powers, Meikle gave Hampton the early 8-3 advantage. More from Meikle, the three-pointer top of the key, gave him an 8-point lead at 18-10. Back come the Spartans, who trailed by as much as 11. Jamel Fuentes finding Jeff Short in the corner for a three-pointer, part of a 14-2 run that put him up by one. And when Zayna Robinson, with time running down in the first half, buries this three as the buzzer goes off, Norfolk State had a 7-point lead at the break, 36-29. He finished with 13. Second half, Sparta starting to put it on the Pirates. Fuentes, the no-look to Rasheed Gaston for the flush. NSU's lead now 40-29. He had 22 points, 12 boards. No quitting the Pirates. On the break, Powers to Meikle for the emphatic slam on two defenders. That cut it to 7. Meikle topped them with 24. Then Powers taking matters into his own hands. His jumper cuts the margin to just 2 at 53-51. He chipped in with 12 points. But Norfolk State kept their distance against their arch rivals. Off the miss, Robinson, the outlet to Short, who had a game-high 26. Sparta with the 80-69 win over the Pirates. They lock up the second seed in the MEAC tournament. Earlier, the Hampton Lady Pirates were honoring their seniors as they look to avenge a loss over a month ago to Norfolk State. The Spartans struggling from the floor. Ray Corbo was their lone scorer in double figures with 11 as they trailed at halftime. By the second half, all Lady Pirates. Keani White, one of those seniors, driving to the lane for 2 and a 30-19 lead for Hampton. Then it was Ryan Jordan's turn. She'll drive left, pull up, draw contact in the foul. Hampton in control at that point, 42-27. She had 10 points. The big game coming from the freshman, Kayla Lupo. First, the nice move inside and the foul. She was one of three Lady Pirates in double figures, leading the way with 20 points, 5 rebounds. Hampton cruises to the 64-49 win. They capture their 5th straight MEAC regular season title. For Inside the Game, I'm Brian Smith.
Let's go down to Birmingham, Alabama, where the SIAC Women's Championship is being held. It should be a good game, but it might not be as much fun as they're having. Watch the championship game. Albany State, Lady Rams, ready. Benedict, Tigers, they're ready too. And Titan Arena, Chisley hits a jump shot. Benedict's got some points on the board. Then they go inside, Christine Lassane, 11 points, 10 rebounds, drives inside and scores. Albany State answers back, 3-point basket. Deborah Hugh comes out on the baseline, knocks down the 3. 3 of 15 shooting for the Rams all night long. They make one when they need one. That's a nice move by Issa Young. She scores. And Carissa Shropshire is going to hit this 3-point. She's all alone in the corner. She knocks it down.
But Albany State's got the lead at the half, 36-32. Second half, man, it's going to get funky. Aisha Young finds Mecca Frost, Mecca with the basket. Albany State forced 27 turnovers. Frost gets the steal, a little shake, a little bake, and the basket, and one. Loving it. Kedra Green faces up, have some, championship style. Then Kiara Jones says, look here, I'm tired of you scoring, so I'm going to face up and I'm going to knock down this jumper. She has 14 points on championship Sunday. Mecca Jones finds Atisha Holston. Holston, 12 points and a friendly rim. The Rams get another steal because of good defense. Pressure on the basketball, gets the steal, pushes it down, and guess who? If you said Frost, you'd be right. 28 points on the day, she's going to be the tournament MVP. Jillian Anderson goes inside, scores for Albany State. They have a 51-40 lead midway second half. Chisley on the fast break gets the layup. But Kedra Green puts any doubt of a championship away with this basket there. She has 13 points. When it's all said and done, there's the buzzer. You know what that means. Champion style, Albany State. Albany State wins their first SIAC championship since 1998. They will advance to the NCAA playoffs with a nice win. 74-64. Champions, SIAC. When we return, the Hornets want to get closer and closer to the top of the race for the SWAC championship. The only thing, they got to find a way to get past those pesky Panthers of Prairie View.